In this session of GPET Kaksha, we will learn about anticholinergic drugs. Anticholinergic means which act against cholinergic system or which acts opposite to cholinergic systems. All anticholinergic drugs act by blocking cholinergic receptors, that is nicotinic and muscarinic receptors. Earlier we have discussed about it that there are two types of cholinergic receptors, nicotinic and muscarinic receptors, which further have different subtypes. And all the anticholinergic drugs are competitive antagonists of cholinergic receptors. Synonyms of anticholinergic drug are antimuscarinic, as it acts against muscarinic receptor, ganglion blockers, those drugs or agent which acts antagonist to NN receptors are known as ganglion blockers. Those drugs or agents which acts as antagonist on NM receptors are known as neuromuscular blockers. These are also known as atropinic. Atropinic means which have actions similar to that of atropine. Parasympatholytic, as these drugs produces the opposite effect of that of parasympathetic system or disable the effect of parasympathetic system, these are also known as parasympatholytic. Atropine is the prototype drug of this class, means the action of this particular drug is considered as actions of all the anticholinergic drugs, which acts as non-selective antagonist at all muscarinic receptor. Non-selective antagonist means it do not acts on a particular receptor. It acts on all the subtypes of muscarinic receptor, that is M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. But it may show the response towards a particular receptor at a certain dose, means dose can vary. It may act at a higher dose on certain receptor to produce its effect, and it may act a certain lower dose as compared to other receptor for producing its effect. All the anticholinergics except atropine and scopolamine are synthetic or semi-synthetic compound. That means atropine and scopolamine are natural acting anticholinergic drug, naturally derived anticholinergic drugs, and other anticholinergic drugs are either synthetic or semi-synthetic compounds. The actions of anticholinergic drugs are firstly on central nervous system. Atropine has CNS stimulant effect, means it stimulates the CNS, increase wakefulness, and scopolamine, also known as L-hyoscine, means levoisomer of hyoscine, has CNS depressing action. In drug-induced Parkinsonism, central anticholinergics are used. Parkinsonism is a disease, and in drug-induced Parkinsonism, the central anticholinergic drugs are used. In drug-induced Parkinsonism, the cholinergic activity increases. So central anticholinergic drugs like benzhexol, benztropine, and bipyridine are used for the treatment of drug-induced Parkinsonism. On CVS, atropine causes tachycardia due to blockade of M2 receptor. As we have already learned that the cholinergic system has a depressing effect on heart. It decreases heart rate. So opposite effect will be produced, that is atropine causes tachycardia due to blockade of M2 receptors. Atropine facilitates AV conduction, thus used in AV block. Atropine facilitates the conduction of impulses through atrioventricular fibers, and thus it can be used in atrioventricular block, in which the conduction through AV node is not proper or blocked. So it will lead to certain kinds of arrhythmia. So in treatment of certain arrhythmias and AV block, atropine can be used. Atropine do not have any significant effect on blood pressure, means atropine do not have any kind of remarkable effect on blood pressure. On eye, atropine causes mydriasis and cycloplegia. Mydriasis is, we have already learnt about meiosis and mydriasis. So, cholinergic drugs produces meiosis, whereas atropine will lead to mydriasis and cycloplegia. Cycloplegia is a temporary paralysis of ciliary muscles, which thus leads to failure in accommodation. Means the our light cannot adjust according to the bright and dark light. So this is a temporary effect. However, for in case of atropine, this effect is very long, 6 to 5 days. So shorter acting mydriatics are preferred for eye examination. We know that during the eye examination, mydriatics are instilled into the eye, so the fundus can be examined. So in general, the shorter acting mydriatics like tropicamide are preferred for eye examination. Atropine is not used because it has a very strong cycloplegic action, that is paralysis of ciliary muscles and very long duration of action. So this will lead to blurred vision for very long days, a very long period of time, which will not be acceptable to patients. So short acting mydriatics like tropicamide are used for eye examination. Anticholinergic tends to increase intraocular tension, thus contraindicated in glaucoma. Whichever drugs which will produce mydriatic action on eye will tend to increase the intraocular tension, and atropine is one of that kind of drug, so they are contraindicated. Anticholinergics are contraindicated in glaucoma, whereas cholinergic drugs are used for treatment of glaucoma because they produces meiosis and tend to decrease the intraocular tension by facilitating uveoscleral outflow. On gastrointestinal tract, anticholinergic decreases tone and contraction of stomach and can be used as antispasmodic. Contraction of stomachs can lead to spasm. Spasm is a painful contraction. So antispasmodics can be action can be obtained through anticholinergics by M3 receptor blockade. The drugs used for antispasmodic actions include clidinium, propanthiline, oxyphenonium, and dicyclomine. Anti-secretory agents like pyrenzepine are useful in peptic ulcer. We know cholinergic drugs leads to increase in secretion, so opposite effect will be produced by anticholinergic drugs. So anti-secretory agent like pyrenzepine, which is an anticholinergic, is useful in peptic ulcer. On respiratory system, cholinergic drugs produces bronchoconstriction, so anticholinergic will produce reverse action, that is bronchodilation. Anticholinergics such as ipratropium and tiotropium are useful in COPD, that is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and asthma. Glands, anticholinergic reduces secretion, thus causes dry mouth, dryness in eyes, dryness of skin, and hyperthermia. What happens? Sweating leads to decrease in temperature of body. Just like evaporation leads to cooling, transpiration of leaves leads to cooling. Likewise, the sweating leads to maintenance of the normal body temperature of our body. So anticholinergics reduces secretion, thus causes dry mouth, dryness of skin, dryness of eyes, and hyperthermia, means elevation of temperature of body, especially in children's. Local anesthetic action, anticholinergics have mild corneal anesthetic action. On genitourinary tract, opposite to cholinergic drugs, anticholinergic decreases motility of urinary tract, hence causes urinary retention. Whereas we know cholinergic drugs used to cause facilitate micturition, whereas anticholinergic decreases motility of urinary tract, so they can be used in treatment of urinary incontinence. Urinary incontinence is a condition in which the control over the bladder is lost. So anticholinergic drugs will lead to can be used in treatment of urinary incontinence, which is a condition in which the voluntarily control over the bladder, urinary bladder is lost, and hence to stabilize the urinary bladder and to decrease its contraction and to increase its stability, anticholinergic drugs such as oxybutynin, flavoxate and tolterodine are used for treatment of urinary incontinence. In case of poisoning, atropine is the drug of choice for mushroom poisoning and in organophosphates and carbamates poisoning. Atropine is the drug of choice for mushroom poisoning and in organophosphates and carbamate poisoning. As we have already learned that organophosphates and carbamates are a type of anti-acetylcholine esterase. Acetylcholine esterase are enzymes which used to break down acetylcholine and thus produces the enhanced acetylcholinesterase are enzymes which prevent the degradation of acetylcholine and thus produced enhanced effect of acetylcholine or extensive cholinergic actions. So the organophosphates and carbamates, these in case of poisoning produces excessive cholinergic effects. So atropine can be used to combat the excessive cholinergic effects caused by organophosphates and carbamates, as well as in case of mushroom poisoning. Organophosphate and carbamates are anti-acetylcholine esterase, and acetylcholine esterase is an enzyme which is which is responsible for degradation of acetylcholine, and thus organophosphates and carbamates prevent the degradation of acetylcholine. For practicing MCQs and to learn important one-liners, follow GPET Kaksha on Instagram. The link of same is given in description. Study well, keep yourself motivated, always keep smiling. Stay tuned for next topic, that is sympathetic nervous system. Thanks a lot.